friendships with each other in the hopes that they will then find the love of their life afterwards. But Justin gives up on the plan, immediately he decides he actually wants the main character, Emma. And then Emma, you know, I feel like she falls at, a more normal pace. So this book was super fun, though. Their dynamic and everything was super cute. crush on from college, who's also a writer, another novelist who gets more acclaim, critical acclaim for his books, because he writes literary fiction and she writes romance, and she feels that people don't treat her, you know, books like the same. So this one is solely her POV. We don't get the love interest POV like we do in Just for the Summer. It's just her POV, and I would have really liked to get Gus's POV. I related to Gus so much more than the female main character, January. Like, Gus kind of was more like closed off and kind of had trouble opening up, and of course, little does she know, like, he, like, you can tell as the reader very quickly, he has feelings for her too, but of course she's like clueless. But I would have liked to have his POV so we could have like seen more of like his thoughts besides just what we got to be able to tell, because yeah, I could tell he was really crazy about her, and yeah, I just found it more relatable. He has a different love interest before her, where he says he like got with her because he felt like she was so like so, what's the word, like self-dependent, like she didn't need him and he felt like he couldn't hurt her. And I feel like I find myself attracted to those types of people too. So, I don't know, I related to Gus too. I think that's like an avoidant attachment style thing or something. I don't know, but yeah, also eventually we see, like we get to see how like crazy about her he is. Like, it's a romance book, of course, but like he truly was like crazy about her. And like, I don't know, I related to him too, because he's literally like in love with this girl, like crazy about her, obsessed with her. You would never guess because of the way he acts. And I found that relatable too. Like, if I like someone, like, 9 times out of 10, you won't be able to tell. Like, I could like someone, and if they mention someone,
She reacted to her daughter.
POVs were really good too, and really the POV following the disadvantaged youth like really tugged at my heartstrings. Like, it was really sad, and yeah, I just felt like this was really well written and felt really like realistic, and then the chemistry between the two main characters was like super hot, and yeah, just really enjoyed it. So yeah, that is 7 Days in June by Zia Williams. All right, so next let's talk a fantasy book. So we have so much, like I'd never read anything like it before. It's a really good book. So I wanted to read something else by them. I picked up The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue, and I'm so glad I did. I really, really, really liked this book, like a lot. Yeah, it is very slow paced. Schwab's book specifically also are really good on audio. Like, I read the first half of it physically and then I switched to audio because like I felt like I was like stopping so often to underline things, and eventually it was like I kept putting it down to focus on other books, but I was really enjoying it, so I wanted to stay in this story and finish this story, but I just was like getting too distracted like with the physical book, so I switched to the audio and then just went back and underlined some parts I really liked while listening to the audio. And I feel like that was really good, like a good choice. Like, the audio for these books, the author's books, are really good. Like, Vicious had such a good audio book narration as well. And yeah, so it is a very slow-paced book, so keep that in mind. If that's not your vibe, then you might not like it. But I did like it. It follows this girl who's like in like the 1800s or something. They're gonna marry her off to a stranger. She doesn't want that. She wants to be able to be free. So she goes and prays to the gods, and her like mentor always told her not to pray to the gods that come out after night. But she doesn't listen. She's desperate, so she does, and one answers. And it's kind of like a deal with the devil type trope. So she asks him, you know, for like more time, and in turn he gives her endless time so long as she agrees to like give him her soul after she's, you know, finished. So he adds a twist, of course, and also makes it so that everyone cannot remember as soon as they turn the back. So if she goes into the store, asks for something, as soon as the person goes to get it, when they come back they're already like, who are you, can I help you, whatever. So whenever she tries to make friends, whatever, it never works because she never can be remembered, and she also can't say her name fully or let other people say her name fully. Like, it's impossible to like write, speak, whatever, so she can never be fully known. It's basically like the curse she's been left with. Let's not talk about her. she goes on this journey with Monique and this other guy that's like going to church with her family, Reggie. They go on this journey with her to find these dilators for her to use. And then, yeah, it's kind of just like a journey of self-discovery along the way. There's also exploration of her, of like the mother-daughter relationship. She always thought her mother was such a villain. And then like her aunt tells her like, oh, like your mom was so cool before she met your dad. Like da-da-da. And yeah, she also has an estranged sister who like moved out and never looked back because of how like strict their parents were and whatnot. And yeah, I really enjoyed this book. I honestly related to the main character a lot. And yeah, I think just certain like shame based like purity culture things can be so harmful. Like so harmful. And yeah, just like reading about like how much she struggled with her own body. Like it was just really relatable. And yeah, I really liked the story. So yeah, if you're looking
books, so I thought this would be like a good
Usually bisexual. Ew. she was doing way too much. Okay, she needed to get it together. But I still related to, you know, some of her feelings or whatever. Like, she was an unlikable. She was an unlikable main character. But I kind of like unlikable main characters sometimes. Like, half the time, I'm like, you know what? I kind of like you and all your unlikableness. Like, I don't know. But yeah, basically, she has a relationship with this dude, like a banker. And he, like, he's like everything she doesn't like. Like, she doesn't agree with him on anything, like politics, like any of that, whatever. She doesn't agree with him. He's like incapable of showing love and affection. Like, they basically just have like a physical relationship. He sees someone else. She eventually starts seeing someone else, whatever. Then she falls in love with this woman. This woman's like, is totally opposite. She's like super emotionally expressive or whatever. And the woman kind of calls her out and is like, you just want to be with someone like this dude who's like not emotionally available with you and like whatever. And so they go back and forth. It's a bit of a love triangle, whatever. The dude doesn't care that she sees someone else. The girl does care. And yeah, they kind of like, she doesn't know how to communicate to the girl what she means to her. And she kind of likes the girl more. Like, she likes them in different ways. And like, she, I found it interesting because she talks at one point, she kind of has to come to terms with she's not.